process of lighting a smoker, keeping it lit, and then also storing it and babysitting it while it cools down. It's a long process.
There's gotta be a better way.
We can just press a button with an electric bee smoker. Let's get into the details. What is an electric bee smoker? The obvious answer is it's a bee smoker that uses electricity. Here you can see a traditional bee smoker, and then you can see electric bee smokers over here. Each of these smokers are a good solution to different problems that we have with the traditional smoker. So today we're going to talk a little bit about electric bee smokers, break it down for you just so you can understand what the differences are. So the way the traditional bee smoker works, it has a heating chamber, it has bellows that pushes air into the hole below, then you have a little metal disc that goes in here to keep all of the combustible material from falling down and making it difficult to burn. So what beekeepers will oftentimes do is use something like pine straw, or they'll use something like burlap that burns slower and smolders a little bit more. They'll put it into the heating chamber. We start the fire using a lighter, or oftentimes using a blowtorch. The blowtorch tends to be the easier of the two. Every beekeeper has a different fuel that they use, a different way that they light their bee smoker. How to start a bee smoker is an entire series, much less an entire video. Let's get on to the electric bee smoker. The first electric bee smoker I'd like to talk about is this one here. The reason I call this the Stearns-style is because it was patented originally by Stern. That being said, there's 1,000 knockoffs on this. Almost every month, there's a different version of this come out, and I'm not exaggerating. It is a very old style, and I think that's part of it. The idea again is that you have the heating chamber here, just like you do with a traditional bee smoker. You have an electric fan here on the side. So when you push the button, it actually pushes the smoke out in the heating chamber. So similar to the traditional bee smoker, combustible materials like pine straw or burlap, lighting it with a lighter or a torch, and then pressing the button and getting smoke out. So this is a very good solution for somebody that has hand problems. I've had a ton of beekeepers tell me that they're thinking of quitting because they're getting older and getting arthritis in their hands and they can't do the bellows anymore. I think that's really sad to basically give up such an amazing hobby as beekeeping. The bellows can be a really difficult thing for somebody to be operating all day long. This is a much better solution, just being able to press a button, hold it. Now that being said, I've not been very impressed with most of these knockoffs that are built, and I don't believe Stern builds these anymore, so I haven't really found a good version of this. This one is awful. Getting the batteries in were almost impossible. As far as the actual product goes, there was absolutely zero documentation on how to do anything with this. It just came like this in a box that was beat up. Again, I'm not endorsing this as a product. Another option is by NumericBees. I've not tried this one before myself, so I can't really recommend it. That being said, it looks like a pretty cool product. And again, you're not using the bellows like you do with a traditional smoker. So if you do have hand issues, it might be a good option for you. But again, I've not used NumericBees before. If you have, put it in the comments below. Tell us how you like it. So now let's move away from combustion smoke using a heating chamber. This product is by Apisolis. It's a really clever device. I have a lot of respect for these guys. They did a great job in building this where they've replaced the heating chamber with a vaporization device. And so if you're looking for a smoker alternative, definitely a solid choice. I met these guys at the North American Bee Expo. They're from France. Damien is the CEO, really nice guy. And so I've had a really good relationship with these guys as well. Again, if you're looking for a smoker alternative, this is definitely a solid choice. ANEL is a really compelling idea. I really think that it's a clever device. It is a hybrid, and the idea behind it is that you have the heating chamber, like you do with the traditional bee smoker. You have the bellows, but you have one of two options. You can either use their vapor pads that they have, and the vapor pads, you pull them out, and you actually stick them onto a heating element that's inside of here. Looks almost like a soldering iron that heats up through a battery that's stored on the back. And then what happens is you can then smoke it using vapor. These vapor pads are just made out of rock wool, and then they have vape liquid in them so that they can vaporize the liquid. And then when it's done, it will actually burn the rock wool. And so you can just use it like you would a traditional bee smoker. I will say also, this has the absolute best bellows I have ever used on any product before, including this one, including every bellows I've ever used. Absolutely fantastic implementation of a bellow. And then regarding the other side of this being a hybrid, you can put the combustible materials into the heating chamber like you would a traditional one. Very flexible way of being able to do one or the other. That brings me to the technically beekeeping smoker. If you want to learn more about this one, I've got plenty of information on my channel. Some of you that have been watching the channel may have noticed this is the first time that I'm actually showing version 8.1. 8.1 is a new prototype that I'm building with a bigger tank. It's actually 10 times the size of the existing tank on this version here. So again, I'm scratching my own itch. I really don't want to have a heat chamber. I want it to be cool to the touch. I don't want it to have a bellows where I have to pump this constantly. I just want it to have a trigger. And I don't want to have it so that it gets so hot that I can't actually put it on a surface. If I had this on a surface while I was running this, this would actually burn the table. It's that hot. Smokers are typically built with a hook so that you can put them onto the side of a hive. And so I wanted to make sure that we could do that same kind of thing. My thought is putting magnets onto the hive where I can just mount them similarly, or you can just put them onto your belt clip and know where it is at all times. I also don't want to have to deal with finding combustible materials, bringing out a blowtorch, all that stuff. I just want to have it all self-contained in one simple unit. And while these are my personal preferences, they may not be yours, so I respect that. To me, it's all about the right tool for the right job. It's all about your personal needs. Make sure that you sign up for the very important Beekeeper Club. There's absolutely no cost to it, and it's just to be able to keep up to date with everything that we're doing. It's just vib.technicallybeekeeping.com.